thank you for joining us today. We're here at La Jolla Esperanza, located about 10 minutes from the beach in Guiones. This is an 11.11 acre project, or 4.5 hectares. It consists of three fully completed homes with rental contracts in place, as well as one other home that's just shy of being completed. Each home has their own private pool. There's a two bedroom, two bath, a three bedroom, three bath, and a four bedroom, four bath. Let's go on inside and take a look around. Okay, we're here at the two bedroom, two bath with private pool. This is located on the easterly side of the project. Beyond this is located some of the gray work and some of the other homes that weren't quite finished that you'll see in our video. We're gonna go inside today and give you a little bit of a virtual walkthrough of this house. In the patio, backyard area is a nice little hangout deck, covered patio, along with the pool. This property, and each one of these properties here inside of the project for the homes that were actually built, they each measure about 7,000 square foot of land, or just a little under a quarter acre. Come on inside, we're going to take a peek. Okay, we're now here at the house that has four bedrooms, four baths, and a private pool in the backyard. This is a little bit different model of the homes that they built here. This one, over the period of time of the construction, they slowly started to change the designs, as you saw in the other two homes. So the first one that we looked at today was a two bedroom, two bath with a private pool, outdoor patio, and then we moved to a three bedroom, three bath with a detached one bedroom from the main house. This one now is the four bedroom, four bath. We're going to walk through. This is the unit that's currently being used as the school. You'll see as we walk around the grounds and everything, the school's installed, a lunch area, swing sets. They also have chickens here at the school, you know, for part of the educational purpose of the kids. The homes have been lived in for several years. I've been part of this project for about 8 years now. So what I like to do on this home, since the renters are away right now, is we're going to walk through. I'm going to give you a little bit more of a guided tour of this house so you can kind of understand granite countertops, individual bathrooms, guest bathrooms, and everything else. So why don't we come on inside and let's do a bit of a walkthrough. Okay, so the four bedroom house that we're in right now, This is equipped with granite countertops, really spacious living room, connected here into the kitchen. There's also two master bedrooms, each with their own bathroom and walk-in closet and everything inside. They're both connected into the main house, as well as a guest bedroom and a visitor's bathroom. The living room and everything opens up right to the patio, as you're gonna see here in our video. It falls right out onto the patio deck and right out to the pool area. The fourth bedroom is actually kind of like a lockout unit, if you will. You go up a set of stairs from the outside, has its own entrance and everything, private bathroom, full closet, everything. We're gonna take a peek at that as well. This house, like I said, is currently being used for the school. So you're gonna notice a lot of different things. Mostly what they're using this here right now is homeschool. Previously, it was actually running classes on a regular basis for several years, but the owner of the school system, she's kind of backed it off. Her name's Paige Wilson, like I mentioned in our phone conversation recently. She's kind of backed it off more now to being just predominantly private classes and things like that, where owners or homeowners and families are coming down and spending some time with their kids several months, 6, 8, 12 months, and they're bringing their curriculum with them. So this is something that we talked about before, and I can also guide you guys to connect with her if you guys would like to continue with this. So let's take a walk through. I'm going to show you guys some of the master bedrooms and everything else, a little bit of the patio, and just give you a good tour, okay? Come on through. Okay, here we are at the final house, this is actually house number one. They built them in reverse. This is house one. The school is lot number, or house number two. The three bedroom was house or lot number three. And then the first house that we took a peek at, which is the two bedroom, two bath with a private pool as well, that one is lot or house number four. This house was the last one to be worked on, and is the one that's unfinished that I mentioned. That I think we can finish this up pretty easily for somewhere around $10,000. If we wanted to add a little bit of extras and things like that, we could maybe, you know, kick in probably close to 20. But this would actually generate a pretty good rental revenue, or from the information that I sent you previously, this one would be a really good fit for a very modest amount of money. We could actually finish it up and have on-site management overseeing the other three houses that are gonna be rented. Come on inside, let's take a look. Okay, here we are at the back of the project. We're located on the other side of the creek. This project, as I mentioned earlier in our phone conversation, there's a creek that runs along the border of the very backside. Now, one of the attributes and the reason we're here, that apart from each home having their own public water connection, this development has two wells. One was located on the very top of the hill, which they put in first. That wasn't a very strong well, so they kind of abandoned it. They left it on the side, because they decided to come down here to the bottom area, where even though there's no water in our creek during parts of the season, this whole valley in the very back, there's natural springs popping out in tons of the different little fingers, or in between each of the ridge lines. So this stream is kind of a runoff for when we get heavy rain or anything like that during the rainy season. But the good thing is this was a very, very deep well, and it's an incredibly strong well. We have a huge water tank on the very top of the hill that you're going to see here in a little bit when we head up there. This well produces water incredibly good throughout the entire year. In fact, I lived back here in this project for several years. One thing that I really noticed was there isn't very much calcium in this water. So as you can see right back here, this is the main well. This well right now is currently being used to pump water up to the very ridge line. It takes us about 3.5 to 4 hours to fill the large tank that you're gonna see in our video a little later on. Okay, so we're gonna head up there now and give you a view out to the ocean, show you the valley, and we'll try and get a view down through the trees right now because it hasn't been trimmed, to see kind of the houses in the air, the kind of an aerial view of the project, if you will, okay? Here we are headed up the hill. We're gonna go up and check out the viewpoint now. We wanted to stop here just for a quick moment because I wanted to show you the whole back side of this development is untouched, literally. So we're going to take a span here, but I want you to see that this whole area back here, this is all untouched. It's lush with all kinds of different fruit trees. It's kind of a big monkey haven. So in this area, you're going to find lime trees, you're going to find mango trees, all kinds of different stuff. In the beginning, when this project was initially started, this was filled with trails and it borders the creek on the back side. And in the development plan that I sent to you guys, it also shows a couple of lots back here. Now this is the side where if another portion of the family was really looking for kind of a little bit cooler climate or a little bit more lush tropical environment and wanted a little bit more privacy, this would definitely be the spot for them. It's got a nice road access right down into the flat area. It's got at least about 2 acres worth of flat land, easy to build with, maybe a hair under, I don't know, right in that region. But this is also accessible off the road that we walked up in order to get up to the main hilltop, which is also where all the water's pumped up to from our well. Let's go up there and take a look, and then we're going to take a peek at the ocean view. Okay guys, here we are at the gem of the project. This is a very hilltop. This has got ocean and valley views. Absolutely beautiful. It's got a nice big area. If we took a little bit of work with the backhoe, we could create a huge, huge flat area up here. Ocean views, we're gonna do a panoramic real quick and show you the valley out to the ocean right now, okay? I'm gonna step out of the way. Okay, so now I'd like to do kind of a quick recap of what we just took a look at today here at La Jolla Esperanza. There's 3 fully functional homes. Each one of them have their own rental contracts in place and are generating income for the developer. Each of them with their own private pool, public water connection, full AC, underground power, cable, phone access, all of the normal public utility needs that you could need for a home and for a development. Apart from that, we also have 2 private wells, one fully functional and being used currently with very good water quality, all being pumped up to a hilltop tank with gravity feed down to the homes. A couple of the things that we discussed that probably need to be done is funds that could be produced from the rental contracts. Replace the line that comes from the main water tank down to these homes. Currently, we have a split system where one line reaches one side of the project, another line feeds off and feeds the other 3 homes on the other side of the project. The easiest way to resolve this, it's about 8 years old, and we have had a couple of breaks and different issues. Sometimes the cattle get in and step on the line. So what I'd recommended, and you'll probably see in the information that I'd sent previously via email, is we should take and lay a new line about 2-inch size and then use a backhoe to cut the trench along the road that you saw in front of the homes, and then just connect into the current existing lines that are feeding the houses. All of the homes also have their own storage facility as well as a pool storage. That's where the pool pump, filter, and everything else is located. So there's a storage unit that's capable for garden materials, whatever you'd like, or just personal goods for each of the renters, as well as a pool storage area that can be used for garden goods if they need it. Now, each of the homes have their own rental contracts, as I mentioned before. So the two-bedroom, two-bath with private pool currently is being rented at $850. This is an old contract, and it expires in August. The other home, the three-bedroom, three-bath, that currently is being rented at $1,100 and expires in August. The other home, the four-bedroom that's with the school, with Paige, I kind of recommend that we maybe keep her on or figure out a way if you guys would like to continue with the school. If not, you have the recommendations in the information and packet that I had sent forward that we've delivered to the developer who has considered moving forward with that package. There's a lot of detail information in there, and as I mentioned in that as well, I've been part of this project for about 8 years now. I know every square inch, and my ultimate goal is to see this development go to a family that would be able to enjoy it as much as I have. The place is beautiful. There's been a lot of kids that have been able to enjoy the area behind us. We have a nice soccer field that's been installed by the school. We have swing sets, this outdoor eating area, which we're sitting in today. This has really been a good point and a good place that I just love it. You know, there's a nice creek in the back. I've taken my cup of coffee and walked the trails with my dog in the mornings. And I think that this is a place, as you guys had mentioned, for something for a family project or a couple of families that would like to enjoy this. There's already three existing homes. The owner was asking 1.6. When I spoke to him, he'd be willing to take 1.2 because he has multiple partners involved. And I think this is something that at 1.2, if you look at the overall size of the project, the fact that it has two different wells, one fully functional with the water system, all the homes having their own pools. If you just break the numbers down with the quality of this construction, concrete block, incredibly hardwood overheads, it was just done very, very good. They didn't skimp at any point on the design or construction of this project. Everything's underground. It was just very well done. Unfortunately, the developers reached a point where he has to step away, his family has to step away, and the investors that are part of this project, they're not going to continue to fund it. It hasn't cost them anything. If you look at the financial reports that the accountant sent over, there's a couple of ways to operate this project. And with the new rental numbers that we've projected, the income to the project actually increases quite well. I just think that this is a project that you and your family could really enjoy. If we wanted to finish out the other house and make it for on-site management, I think that your numbers would do very, very well. If you didn't want on-site management, then the management monthly fee might have to change a little bit, but that's beside the point. The point is that this wouldn't cost you anything if we operate it correctly, and it's ran as a long-term rental. You know, I truly believe in this project, and I think that this is something that if the right people got involved, they it could just become incredible. If you didn't want to keep the houses that are here, you could sell each one of them off, and we put them on the market for something simple, like around $200,000, maybe a hair above, and we sell them off individually. Now, if you look at that, there's four of them. So the overall return there could be close to around $800,000 for something we're paying $1.2 million for, and you end up with about 3 hectares or over 6 acres of land left with a private water system. So I think it's just I think it would be a very good move, especially if it was a multiple family group, because you can work with the rental contracts so that when you guys are ready to retire and you decide that you really want to move here, we can take homes offline or drop the rental contracts, and you have a place you can immediately move into, and the family can all enjoy it. And we're only 10 minutes away from the beach. You got an immense amount of land and a beautiful area. You can add a pool. You guys could start a school. You could do a business. You can do cabinas for rent. The options are limitless. I just think it's a very good move, and I really hope you guys see in this project what I do. If you guys have any questions, please reach out, let me know, and I look forward to your comments. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Have a great day.